Hi, I'm Dr. Traci Stein, and this program is designed to help you more easily tap into your own intuitive guidance. I've studied a number of different methods of intuitive development over the years. What I've learned along the way is that whether you felt intuitive for most of your life or are just beginning to explore this for yourself, by engaging the power of your mind and using tools like guided imagery, you can more easily access your vast reservoir of intuitive wisdom. This is because we all have the capacity to become more in touch with our own inner guidance. Exercising your intuitive muscles can have a number of benefits. These include helping you learn to recognize and trust your instincts across a variety of everyday situations at work, home, and elsewhere. In order to get the most out of this program, there are five key things that I'd like you to keep in mind along the way. The first key is that attitude is everything. So maintain an attitude of trust, openness, and curiosity. With regard to the trust part of this, I mean that you should expect that you are intuitive and that your answers will be helpful and accurate. As for openness and curiosity, you'll want to cultivate an observing rather than a judging type of awareness. One way to facilitate openness is to meditate. Meditation clears your mind and centers you, so you can observe what comes through without trying to change, evaluate, or interpret it. Sometimes the most accurate intuitions seem the strangest before you receive confirmation. So again, adopting an open, non-judgmental attitude is key. If you already have a meditation practice, you'll be ahead of the game here. The second thing to remember is that just like learning to play an instrument or develop any other skill, practice is key. So strive to set aside time each day to listen to the imagery. Third, your results will be the most helpful and accurate if you clearly formulate and state your intention ahead of time. So, for example, if your intention is to tune into what tomorrow's lead newspaper story will be, state that. Same thing if your intention is to tune into what you'll need to focus on to ace a job interview, or tap into which route to work will have the least traffic, or if you want to gather accurate information while trying to help out a friend. The more concrete and specific you can be with formulating your intention, the better. Fourth, jot down your insights while they are fresh, and keep a journal of your results and anything else that seems important about your process. Doing so will help you become better at recognizing the subtle but definite difference between true intuitions and other thoughts and feelings you may have. It will also help you keep track of your successes, providing valuable feedback and reinforcing your efforts. I recommend buying a notebook or journal specifically for keeping track of what you notice. Let it be one that you use for this purpose alone. Fifth and finally, have fun with this and allow yourself to enjoy the process. You'll actually have better results over time if you create space for your intuition rather than trying to force or judge it. So, in summary, the five key elements are: keep an attitude of openness, curiosity, and trust, practice regularly, clearly formulate your intention, keep a journal, and have fun with the process. I should also point out that no one is 100% accurate all of the time. We all have the tendency to view what we discern through our own personal filters. No one knows everything, but with practice, you may be pleasantly surprised to see your intuitions become more and more on target. And remember, your intellect and common sense will ultimately help you decide what to do with the information you receive. With regard to this audio program, you'll notice I've included three main tracks to help you open up, tune into what you want to know, and close down once you are finished with your intuitive work for the time being. The opening track features a combination of some of my favorite imagery for using the chakras, or energy centers, as the gateway to receiving intuitive information or preparing for any other intuitive or healing work. The second track is designed to facilitate your setting a specific intention, creating space for information to come through in whatever way it presents itself, and also to become a more finely tuned instrument over time. And the third track is geared toward formally completing your session by closing down, clearing, and grounding afterwards. In some ways, this is the most important of the three tracks, as it prevents you from carrying around unwanted debris, such as other people's emotions or information after your work is done. It helps you to maintain good psychic boundaries, which are actually just as important as having good interpersonal boundaries in daily life. The imagery on the closing down track will also help you feel grounded and properly reoriented to the normal everyday world, so you can do all of the other things you need to without feeling spacey. Finally, I've included two brief bonus tracks with additional exercises you can try to further strengthen your intuitive practice. With each track in this program, you may find it useful to listen to a particular segment or image and then pause it until you are ready to go on to the next one. This will give you ample time to tune in and jot down what you notice. As with any imagery, don't play it when you're driving or otherwise need to pay strict attention to something. I'm honored to be part of your journey. And now, let's begin. This first imagery will help you open up and balance your energy centers and get in a more receptive state. It's basically the intuitive equivalent to setting up your antenna so you can more easily and precisely tune into what you want to know while still remaining grounded. It's actually one of my favorite ways of preparing for intuitive work. So, have your journal and pen or pencil at the ready, so you can take note of what you notice. If you like, you can set the stage for the work to come by lighting a candle or using a pleasant essential oil. So, you can begin by finding a comfortable and private space where you can shift your focus to the imagery and let everything else be off to the side for the time being. And sitting comfortably now, with your head and neck and spine gently and easily aligned, just breathe, allowing your breath to clear your mind. With each inhalation, drawing in clarity and peace. And with each exhalation, allowing yourself to sweep aside any mental debris. Just continue that cycle of centering meditative breath, with your focus first on the sensations
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.